Here's your host, health and wellness correspondent, Lee Kelso.
Hey, good morning. So glad to be back with you again. It is the favorite part of my week, and I'm really thrilled that you made time for us in your busy Saturday morning. So I've got some really great news about the COVID pandemic coming up in the top of the second half hour, but we're going to talk a little bit about COVID and how it's affecting all of us this time around. The layoffs, the lockdowns, the deaths of more than 450,000 Americans. It's really led to a surge of depression and anxiety disorders. Doctors are prescribing mood-altering drugs at a furious pace. Suicide among teenagers has now grown to become the number two leading cause of death. So clearly, it's having a big impact on us all across the country. I found a British neuroscientist named Dr. Dean Burnett, who says all this year-long upheaval, the layoffs, the uncertainty, the fear is really taking a toll on our brains. His theory is that constant exposure to stress-related chemicals is really causing our neurons that control mood and behavior to just kind of burn out. He describes a condition known as anhedonia, which is the inability to feel joy or pleasure. Now, it affects people differently, but it's all the result, he says, of neurons just being sort of burned out from all the stress that we've had to go through. So when I read that, I thought immediately about Dr. Thomas Lazoff from Physical Medicine Consultants and the MindSET treatment that he has brought to Fort Wayne. Its job is to stimulate neurons and really kind of get them back on the job, get them back into the game. So Dr. Lazoff, thanks for joining us again this morning.
Thank you for having us again, Lee. It's a pleasure to be here.
And also with him this morning is Jody Isbell, registered nurse. She sort of manages the program, the MindSET program for Dr. Lazoff. Glad you're here this morning.
Thank you. Good to be here.
I think I'm going to need you a little closer to the microphone before the end of the show. So I want to touch on MindSET because I think it's a really interesting treatment. I have been treated for concussion. My wife was treated for concussion. I have seen it work for patients with depression and anxiety. So I want to explain to people, how can something that doesn't involve drugs have that much impact for so many people?
Well, the what we do at PrTMS MindSET at our clinic is we train the brain to fire in unison. So just like we have our own little our heart rate, our brain has its own beat as well. The interesting thing about the brain, it doesn't matter what the insult is. It could be depression, anxiety. It could be COVID fog. It could be chemo brain, concussion, like you were treated for. But the common theme is that the neurons in the brain are not firing in unison. So consequently, if there's damage to the brain, whether it's inflammatory or just stress related, you can have all the neurons start to slow down. You can have anxiety in which some of the neurons speed up, and so they're out of sync. And so our job is to use the strong magnet to then treat the patients and kind of have them train their brain. It's like training for a marathon or a race or anything.
So you're just kind of bringing those neurons back into sync. And the magnet you mentioned pulses electromagnetic energy through the skull into the brain. We're going to talk about the science behind all that a little bit later on.
Okay.
But Jody, I wanted to get to you and have you tell me a little more about what you see in patients as you walk them through the course of this treatment over time.
So usually when patients come to us, they have been dealing with depression, anxiety, their symptoms for a long time. And they've tried medications, they've tried psychotherapy, and sometimes those things work to an extent, but oftentimes patients are still dealing with and having thoughts of suicide. Patients have told me on a daily basis, I'm making the attempt to get up every day and just tell myself that I'm going to get through this day today, one day at a time. Mm. And by the time they get to us, they are just really struggling. And so, we sit down with them and say, what have you tried? What's not working and why? And make a plan, a treatment plan for them. So,
and then how soon do you see patients start to respond? This is a daily treatment that can take a period of weeks to get through, but how quickly do people sort of show some, like something's happening, something's changing?
Yeah, typically we tell them that they may not see a response right away, but most of the time patients are telling us within the first couple of weeks that that they're noticing something is different, that they're noticing an improvement in their mood, starting not to feel quite as gloomy every day. They are sleeping a little bit better every night, whether that be for a longer period or just feeling more rested in their sleep. Those are the first signs, and usually that's within the first couple of weeks.
So, doctor, what conditions respond to this? So we've, Jody mentioned depression, anxiety, but what else responds to this treatment?
Well, we have patients like yourself that have had trauma that have disrupted the neurons, and so people have headaches that we can treat that have had chronic headaches due to a TBI or a concussion, chemo brain, radiation brain, anything that there's been an insult to the brain and causes the disruption in the way that it fires. And I think the important thing to know is that medications can do that too, right? Mm-hmm. So if somebody's been on, they're on two or three antidepressants and then a medication to speed their brain up, medicines to slow their brain down, all that plays havoc with the way that our brain fires. And so we've seen improvement all across the board. We've treated autistic kids, children on the spectrum, a lot of concussions and depression, anxiety, PTSD. Addiction.
It's pretty remarkable breadth of conditions that you're treating. Jody, what are you seeing in these patients? Does this last? Is it a permanent solution for them?
For many of the patients, it is a lasting result. We have treated a large number of patients at our clinic, and they've not come back to us saying that their symptoms have returned. We do have a handful that we have seen back in the office for treatment. They've noticed that, especially this time of year between the holidays and February, seemed to be a spike of depression type symptoms, and they'll say, I'm noticing those symptoms are starting to come back, and before they get too bad, they want to come in and we can do a shorter set of treatment for those patients.
I call that the February funk. I get it every year. Maybe I should come in for a little tune-up and tweak the brain.
You're more than welcome.
Tweak the brain around a little bit. COVID is affecting many people in different ways. So in addition to the anxiety and depression, there's also the thinking that people are saying that they are recovered from the disease, but still foggy brain. They can't think straight. They just don't get it on ball yet. Are you seeing any effect there? Is this going to help those folks?
We have yet to treat a COVID patient for brain fog like you were talking about. I mean, we're looking for those patients to see what the response will be. I would anticipate that the response will be favorable just because it is an insult to the brain, just like anything else. And we were talking earlier before the show, there's the inflammatory component on the brain. There's now research that says, hey, maybe it's lack of blood flow to the brain based on a variety of things. So all of that is still an insult. So I would consider it almost like a viral encephalitis or a chemo brain, anything that's damaged the neurons.
So reason to believe that it will be effective, but you don't have any hard evidence yet.
Correct.
Very good. Hey, we're going to take a commercial break. And when we come back, we're going to dig a little deeper into how this treatment works, what the process is to see if you might be a candidate, what the evaluation period looks like, all of those things as we continue here on the Health Call Live Radio Hour with Dr. Thomas Lazoff and Jody Isbell from Mindset PrTMS. Hope you'll stick around. We'll be right back. And I'm here with Dr. Thomas Lazoff from Physical Medicine Consultants, where they perform a treatment called Mindset PrTMS. Also with him today is registered nurse Jody Isbell. We're talking about mindset as it applies to treatment of symptoms associated with depression and anxiety. I got to tell you, I've been around this treatment for a while. I have seen it have a real impact on patients, and the patients will tell you, I've tried every kind of medication out there that the doctor could provide me and nothing worked, but this did. So we discussed earlier the fact that this is really stimulating neurons to bring them up to the job that they're supposed to be doing. How do you know what's going on inside my brain, and how do you evaluate me as a patient?
Well, we use a EEG, a four-minute EEG, about every five treatments. So first of all, we can evaluate you initially with the EEG and some written tests that we have you fill out. And so that kind of gives us an idea of how your brain is firing. It's one picture in time, but it gives us a feel for where you're at.
And so an EEG, for those who aren't up to speed on that, that's an electroencephalogram. You're actually watching the electrical pulses in my brain.
Correct. Yes.
Okay. So that shows you the areas of the brain that are too slow. What is it showing you?
It shows us too slow, too fast, not enough, and it looks the way your brain fires from the back part of your brain to the front part of your brain. So, like when we see somebody, like I look at Heather and I think, okay, now I see Heather, I'm going to go shake her hand or whatever. So all that goes through the process of the flow of the brain, and there's an inherent, like we talked earlier, there's an inherent brain beat, and if it's not in unison, it's just not going to work correctly. I might stutter. I might, not move correctly. And that's just a simple explanation. But when somebody's depressed, you know, all those neurons are firing too slow. And so they're just not able to think clearly. And that's the big part, is to be able to make decisions and think clearly mm-hmm. on a routine basis.
And Jody, can you recognize now, you've seen enough patients, can you look at a brain wave and kind of get a sense for what the symptoms might be?
You can usually coordinate or correlate those symptoms with what you're seeing on an EEG. You know, you can pick up on depression type symptoms on the EEG or sleep interruption on the EEG.
Yeah. And that's how you know the patient is moving along. Not only they tell you they're getting better, but you can see the progress in the EEG?
Correct.
Okay.
So it gets crisper. I wish we could do a visual here, but yeah. It could be correlated to a radio station where you're almost firing perfectly, but you're just a little bit off the 1190, you're 1180, let's say, and you're off the frequency a little bit, and you can see that on the EEG, and then the treatment then gets everybody on at 1190.
So you are passing pulses of magnetic energy through my skull into my brain, and then what happens there?
Then
it sounds painful, but it's painless. I've been through it, so I know that.
Correct. And if you think about the original, the grandfather of all this was ECT, thank you. I needed tune-up with Jack Nicholson. Well, this is a little bit different. So the energy goes through the skull, and then it releases a couple centimeters below the bone or below your skull. Mm-hmm. And then it releases the energy to stimulate those neurons to fire.
And so you're trying to get them back into sync with that primary frequency of the brain. And once that happens, everything starts to work more effectively. That's the theory. I get that. So this process is daily for how long?
It is daily. It's Monday through Friday. It takes about 30 minutes each day. Typically, most patients are there for 6 to 8 weeks. 6 weeks is usually about the minimum in order to sustain the response to those neurons and keep the progress that you've maintained or achieved during those few weeks.
And during that half hour of treatment, I'm actually very comfortably reclining in a chair. And what's going on around me?
It's kind of a fancy lazy boy chair that you get to sit in, recline in, and the magnet is held by a vise so it can be positioned for every patient individually. There's 3 or 4 different positions that we put the magnet in through those 30 minutes. And then the EEG and the symptom questionnaires that you've answered all determine what we set the machine to run at for those 30 minutes. So everybody's individualized, personalized treatment for those 30 minutes.
So what is, let's talk about the uncomfortable stuff now. Does insurance cover this?
insurance will cover sometimes. It's not 100% certainty that insurance will cover, but certain policies do offer a TMS benefit as long as the patient has, unfortunately, they have to try and fail other conservative treatments, so medications, psychotherapy, counseling sessions. If they can say that we've tried these things and they're not working for me, or I'm not getting the maximum relief with those, some insurance policies will cover TMS.
And if I have to pay out of pocket, what is the cost of the therapy?
Yeah, it's a good investment. You know, we kind of look at it as you're paying a large amount of money for all these years with medications and treatments that may or may not be working at all. So, mm-hmm. You know, it's about a $5,000 investment for a month of treatment.
Let's talk a little bit about autism and kids on the spectrum. So I think we've covered depression and anxiety and PTSD we did not discuss, but that also responds to this treatment. What kind of results are you seeing in kids who are on the spectrum?
So we've had, I say kids, but they were young adults that we treated with autism, and their parents would say that they are able to communicate a little bit more clearly with not only family, but in their social realm, a little bit more verbal. Their verbal skills have improved. They are less anxious, less repetitive type motions and movements, just feel a little bit more relaxed. They're sleeping better in the night, and as a family whole, that really improves family life when everyone is sleeping better and feeling better.
Yeah, no kidding. I discovered this therapy in Indianapolis, actually, before you brought it to Fort Wayne, and so I talked to a number of families down there, and just the point you made, Jody, so many moms have told me, if nothing else, if this helps my autistic child sleep through the night, that's a gift for the entire family.
Yeah, absolutely.
And there have been a lot of other gains that have come along from that. Where's this therapy going? What's next? What's on the horizon? Is there something new that's happening?
There are. I think the down the road you'll start seeing this maybe at home. So it's a little bit more convenient for individuals to do that. That would be one thing that's down on the horizon. The patients do like coming in, though. They enjoy coming in as well. You know, they get out of the house, mm-hmm. especially during the pandemic. I mean, sure. We had a slowdown, obviously, a year ago until everything kind of sorted out. But they also they enjoy coming, but eventually it'll be at the house, at your own house.
So tell me about the process for evaluation. If I think this might be something I'm interested in, what does that look like? How does that work? What do I do?
You give us a call and talk to me. We will kind of go over what your symptoms are, what you would like to see improve and get better. We talk about what you've tried, what you've failed, where you've been treated before, and get our hands on some of those records, get insurance involved if we need to, and see what they will approve for you.
And I'd also like to say that we, try to keep in contact with other healthcare providers that are involved with the individual patient as well. And a lot of times they're still going to need their therapy in conjunction with the treatment that we offer. It's not necessarily a standalone treatment.
Oh, it's not either or. So I continue taking my medications or seeing my counselor at the same time?
Correct. And then some patients, we've had one recently just opted to just take himself off. He forgot to ask us, but took himself off all of his medications. And so those are things that the treatment may last a little bit longer when somebody's trying to wean off some of their medications. But still, it's a combination approach.
Okay. We have to leave it there. Thanks very much. That is Dr. Thomas Lazoff and registered nurse Jody Isbell from Physical Medicine Consultants briefing us on Mindset PrTMS. It is a drug-free treatment for the symptoms of depression, anxiety, and other conditions. If you're interested, you can always go to MindsetPrTMS.com. That is MindsetPrTMS.com. And there you'll find a couple of videos, patients telling kind of their experience and sharing more about the treatment and how it it all works. So if you are troubled with depression, anxiety, and other issues that just can't get under control, I invite you to give it a look. I have seen it work well for many people.